they did?
I think you described a tampon as a tiny rocket.
Clumps.
Yeah, clumps were mentioned many times.
Yeah.
It was very disturbing, actually, that Tom knew the word clumps. That's really disgusting.
Yeah. I will say that not having a period is one of the best things to be pregnant. One of the few very exciting ones are both pregnant. Because I'm really not one of those types of women who really loves being pregnant. Some women are just like,
this is my destiny.
I sort of want to be like, no, I was born to drink, so this is preventing me from doing that. So, but not having periods is anyone else not have periods recently?
I feel like if anyone else did have a period, that wouldn't be great right now if you're not trying to have a baby.
Well, there's other ways. There's some sort of birth control that prevents it happening.
I'll even take birth control because
every wallet. Up your twat, you never loving son of a bitch. You just got it, and then there's, let's see, oh, yeah, this one, this one. This looks like a great party. There's lots of, like, you know, elderly people, like seniors, like maybe a retirement party.
Seems like it.
But then Judy, which one's Judy?
Yeah, that's me, I'm Judy.
Judy said, old people shouldn't be eating cake, you should be in the ground, dead and buried with all the other old people, you stupid, stupid assholes.
Yeah, Judy, yes.
And then if you look at the title of that, they said, holes continued, like that's continued.
Oh, yeah, you put another comment, you replied to your original, and just holes.
Yeah.
To three S's.
To really hit on the point that I think old people are assholes.
They are.
They deserve to live.
Yes.
Right. And that one, you know, I was like, okay, well, that's just mean and a little crazy, but then I saw this one, and it was from Judith, so I'm assuming that's you.
That is Judy and then Judith.
Yeah.
That's how we differentiate.
I'm glad, because that helps, but this one just says, I love Donald Trump.
Yeah. No.
That's the worst one.
Why? Yeah, which one's a big fan of cake?
There are lots of the wow, and I don't think people mean like, wow, me too, I think they mean like, wow.
No, they mean like, I want a baker who only bakes white cakes.
With me, then grab it on. If you're not,
You ever had anything really embarrassing happen to you? You sit over there.
Like, in that life?
Yeah, ever. No. I had period wise.
Oh. Are we still talking about periods? Cool.
Yeah.
Are you embarrassed about it?
No. Or women, what do you think?
I don't know. I feel like that's just like a typical thing for women.
Exactly.
Being told we're talking about periods.
All right. Well, I'll tell you about
what about
shipping. Oh, it's coming for you someday, and I'm like, no. And I was dating somebody new, and I made him dinner for the first time, and I got so sick, and I was vomiting, and he was very sweet, and he was like, oh, let me hold your hair back, and I was like, no, just let's not do this. And he fell asleep, and in the middle of the night, I woke up, and I was like, oh, no, what happened? And I shit my pants a little bit. And I've never in my life moved so quietly, but so quickly. I like scooted out of bed and like stealth into the bathroom, just ripped my pants under off, threw them out my fourth floor window. And, like, one fell swoop, and I was like, I took a shower and I went out with like the flashlight of my magnifying or my like phone to see if anything was anywhere, and it wasn't. And I was just like, I just laid there for like 2 hours. I couldn't fall back asleep because I was afraid it would happen again. Just sweating.
Wait, you went outside with your phone flashlight?
I didn't go outside. I left. The next day when I'm at my house, there's just a little pile of like my leggings.
At least they were still there. I thought you said that you went and looked for them and they were gone.
They were gone a couple days later.
Someone took your pants?
I mean,
someone took the pants.
You should have picked up the next day.
I couldn't walk over. I was with him. I couldn't just be like, oh, hold on.
I got to take care of them.
Don't mind those. And I was like, did you like notice something? He was like, no, why? Are you okay? And I was like, no, I'm not okay. And then he got sick, but must have been the same thing a few days later. And he's like, I've been throwing up all night. And I was like, so
do you think he threw shitty pants out the window?
I don't think so.
Just like,
yes.
I don't know if I've ever shit my pants. I guess I can take that spot now.
I don't know. Yeah, you.
I have. At least twice. As an adult woman.
Weird.
Yeah, disgusting. Yeah. Well, one time I wasn't wearing anything. One time I was naked, but I was in a hotel room with a gentleman, and we had just finished the activities, morning activities, and he was in the bathroom, and I was like, oh no, and I just let out like the tiniest shark within the bed. And I was like, so I like stripped the bed while he was in the bathroom, and I was like, oh, it's so wet from the sex and the like, just.
Can it seem weird to you? Get ready.
because there's a lot more that I can do. Don't underestimate me.
Okay.
I mean, I believe you.
So, I mean, it's not like this is something that happens every day, you know?
Not to you, maybe. Yeah.
Oh, honey, what's the matter? He didn't like your American Girl doll collection?
No!
What did she
know? I hated it. He said it was eloquent and violent. I did set them up and he murdered me, but it was only accurate to where they were in society and in history at the time.
I thought you were on American Girls and Boys Friends.
They're all about that. The website meant that you would find a husband who shared your love for American Girl dolls.
No, it's that he likes American Girls.
Oh my God!
It's okay, honey. It's okay. We're gonna get through this. You can dust yourself off and try again, just like Olivia said. You're gonna get up and find yourself a new man, okay?
Okay.
So, we have to get all the dolls ready. We have to get all the dolls ready. You have to wash them and do the whole routine tonight.
Okay.
I know it's 4 in the morning, but we have to do it tonight.
Thank you, Mom.
You're welcome.
We love you.
Cool dolls.
Do you really think so?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is Samantha. She's a Victorian English girl. She's very wealthy. Don't let her look at some of the other dolls. They were poor. It makes them feel bad.
Cool.
Yeah.
Who's this one?
That's Addie. She was the first black doll.
I'm going to hold on to her.
Yeah, she's actually my favorite one.
She seems smart. Just like you. So you ever set them up in murder scenes?
Yeah, oh my God, yeah, all the time. But I like to, I don't know. It's usually like a crime of passion. I don't like to assign any like psychotic traits to my dolls because I feel like that is unfair to people who murder.
Sure, yeah, yeah, no, I mean, and they're all people.
Yeah.
Families and stuff.
Sure, so the one I feel least bad about killing is Kirsten.
Yeah.
She has dumb braids, and also she already was dead. Or her friend was. I can't remember.
I don't know. I think at this point, they're mostly dead. Definitely the American Revolution one, the like the World War II.
Molly.
They are all dead. Well, these ones are all just like custom dolls I made.
Yeah, they all look like you.
But they are alive. And they, they do all the time.
You ever set up murder scenes with real people?
Not yet, but I'm GGG. So,
well,
I'm open to whatever.
Great, I'm gonna take my pants off.
Scroll good. Going real good. How are you?
Thanks, Matt.
Welcome. You didn't fail at this like you failed at most other things you tried. Good job.
I really wanted to show you I could do it this time.
Yeah.
I know after the last time I failed, and you took out an ad in the newspaper for, take my failed daughter. You know, I really
Please.
Yeah. I really wanted to prove to you that I am worth it.
Yeah. Well, let's not get ahead of ourselves.
Okay, sorry. They're just sprouting up, so, you know, they could die at any time.
Whoa.
Should they be in the shape, do you think?
Oh, man.
Yeah. Do daisies grow in the shape?
I don't know if this is a trick question.
I don't either. I'm not a gardener. I'm
just going to open the shades halfway. Mom.
Yes, sweet.
I know why you're so hard on.
Why is that?
Because every time you look at me, you're reminded of Dad.
You don't
say his name.
Or the nickname that he has given because of what he did.
Shithead.
Yeah. Or Dad.
Shithead Dad.
Yeah. We don't say any of those things, do we?
I do in secret. I want to live with Shithead Dad. Shithead Dad thinks I'm good. And he rewards me even for my failures. He's like a typical American dad.
You know, maybe you should go live with Shithead Dad.
Shithead.
Yeah. Shithead Dad. Maybe I should go live with him.
Okay. Maybe that would make you feel better, because two failures, 1 + 1 = 9.
I'm going to pretend that I fail math just to make you feel better. You're right. 1 + 1 = 9.
When you go see your shithead dad, why don't you ask him who his real daughter is?
All right, what kind of goddamn question is that? You're my real daughter. Your mom, beautiful woman, crazy as hell. Yes. And mostly I think she's crazy because she disagrees with me a lot.
How can you prove that I'm your daughter? What if crazy batshit mom is right? That's what you have in common.
And you're not my daughter.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't think that's possibly true. You mess stuff up all the time.
I do.
I mess stuff up all the time. We both think Ziggy is funny. Nobody else thinks Ziggy's funny.
Ziggy is funny.
I know. Okay? And that's genetically inherited.
Crazy shit. Mom is getting in my head.
You can't let her. Right?
I know. I'm trying to be strong, but you know I'm a failure.
You're not a failure. You're just bad at stuff. There's a big difference. All right? Am I a failure? Hell no. Look at this house. Look at that poster. I hung that up. Is there a frame on it? No.
And it doesn't matter that there's no roof on this side of the house.
Who cares? It's some roof.
Yeah.
Yes. I am bad at making a home. Yes, that is true. But I am not a failure. I have a home, and even if I was homeless, I would still be successful because I made you. And you are great, even if you're bad at something. And if your mom wants you to be good at something, why don't you tell your mom to be good at something? What's she good at anyway?
Not a lot.
None of us are good at things. That's how your mother and I wound up together. We accepted each other's badness until one day she did get sick of me being worse than her in many ways and left.
I think she's upset. That's why she's been so mean to me. I think, you know, she's jealous of the bond that you and I have.
You're right. She's jealous of me.
Sure. Mom is so uptight, you know? You get to make all the mistakes and you still get to be the cool parent.
That is true.
If I was mom, I would be bitter and upset too. I would let it age be the way it's aged her.
30 minutes late, Ronald?
Well, you know.
This Applebee's is open 24 hours. You're fucking lucky.
Yeah. I miss you yelling at me. I miss this.
How is she?
She's great. She's doing great. She loves the sunroof. She loves my Federal poster. Be like him when I grow up. I'm like, well, nowadays. I'm gonna be honest with you. If she misses you a little bit.
You would say that. You get to stroll in and just be the cool shithead dad.
I know. Listen, I'm not denying that. I didn't make society's rules. I just live by most of them